another Major League Rugby Sunday in Toronto, this time downtown Toronto, as for the first time, Lamport Stadium plays home to the Toronto Arrows, the favorite sons of Canada here in MLR. They welcome to town San Diego, a team that is looking to get back to the top of the MLR standings here in year two. After New Orleans yesterday with the victory, just able to edge them out. We welcome you into the broadcast, everyone. Lincoln Rose along with Kit McConico. And Kit, already an exciting weekend. Two games down yesterday, another pair here today to wrap up another entertaining week as we're in the back half of year two here in MLR.
Exactly right, Lincoln. 75% past of the season. And well, it's crunch time for all these teams. It is must win to get into the top four.
Speaking of that top four, we take a look at the standings. Again, the Gold with the win yesterday, inch ahead of the Legion. Now the Legion with a win today in Toronto could either tie or perhaps go back ahead if they can find another try bonus. Glendale yesterday took care of business. We'll see that final score in just a moment. Seattle, Rugby United, Toronto, all in that murky area right around the cutoff line. Let's take a look at, again, what has already unfolded this week. As yesterday, Glendale again took care of business against Utah to put pressure on the other teams trying to get into the top four, while New Orleans able to sweep Austin over there at Gold Stadium. Later on tonight, it will be the Sabercats and Rugby United. Well, looking at, again at our matchup here for Toronto, they're enjoying their first ever winning streak now in their first season in MLR. How they stretch it from two games to now three in a row, perhaps?
Well, it's about the scrum. One of the best in the league. It's going to be a real advantage for the home team. They have to take advantage there. And takeaway, San Diego leads the league in handling errors, forced the Legion to turn the ball over in momentum. As you said, they've won two in a row. They dominated the defending champions, holding the Seawolves to just 7 points. See if they can continue today against the red-hot Legion team.
Yeah, if you like two-game winning streaks, how about a five-game streak, six matches unbeaten? How do the Legion get back to the top of the table?
Hands down, the hottest team in the league, and for them, it's about playing fast. Second in the league in total points scored, the backline boys, the best backs in the entire league. The real strength of this team, get them the ball, let them do the work and discipline. They lead the league in penalties conceded. They have to play smart today, and they can't give Toronto opportunities.
Well, as for individuals you want to keep an eye on, I know you're excited each and every Sunday about the captain, Dan Moore.
It's hard to say too much about Dan Moore, the native son of Toronto. What he's been able to do last week, set a Major League Rugby single game record, 19 carries, 172 meters gained, had a line break and six tackles on defense in that win over Seattle.
And of course, for the Legion on the road, the man that's going to lead the way for them was, well, our man of the match last time we saw San Diego pick up the win last weekend in Mikey Teo.
One and only, the machine Mikey Teo, and what a relief it is that he is back healthy, not just with the Legion, but with the USA Eagles as well. Outstanding player last week, eight carries, 92 meters, two tackle breaks, and when he gets the ball, hold your breath.
A couple of teams hitting their stride on a collision course north of the border. Arrows, Legion, 80 minutes coming up next.
Thank you.
Well, the stage is set at Lamport Stadium for its Major League Rugby debut as the Arrows slide to downtown Toronto. Let's take a look at the starting lineups. First up for the Arrows, and understandably, the Arrows not making many changes among the forwards, just John Moonlight returning from not international duty, but from firefighting duty. And as for the backs, just a little shuffling.
Yeah, one big change at 12 there at inside center as Pat Parfrey will take over for Joseph Dutoit. Three players from last week's Major League First 15, Brower, Shepherd, Wainwright, Moore, four, all playing today.
Pat made his MLR debut off the bench last week, now his first start with his new club. As for San Diego, well, you know the phrase, if it's not broke, don't fix it. Five straight wins, six straight unbeaten, and yet, well, they are trying to fix a few things.
Yeah, the hottest team in the league, also four players from last week's first 15, and the spine so good, Nasekeke, Augsburger, Peterson, Teo, those are the guys to watch out for.
A lot of changes up front. The backs, for the most part, unchanged from their last win. Lincoln Rose, Kit McConico with you, and for the first time today, a chance to check in with Sarah Davis down on the pitch. Sarah?
Hey guys, yeah, Pat Parfrey making his first pro start for the Arrows today at center, and he has 27 international caps to his name. He's played alongside Lucas Rumble for Team Canada, and I spoke with Rumble before today's game. He talked about how Parfrey's a guy, a lot of fun, but he doesn't necessarily give off the scholarly vibe. But get this, Parfrey's in the midst of completing his PhD in clinical epidemiology. That's a mouthful, focusing on stroke victims specifically. And Rumble told us Parfrey is the ultimate work hard, play hard kind of teammate on and off the field, guys.
Yeah, and Pat, of course, comes from a rugby family, but love finding out what all the side passions are for these various players in this sport. I feel like rugby players, more than anybody else, really men of multiple talents.
Oh, they are indeed. It's so impressive. You have scholar athletes, what they're able to do both on and off the pitch, so successful as pro players, and then in their later lives when their careers wrap up, always great to see what they turn to.
Well, downtown traffic in Toronto appears to be pretty clear. As able to deliver this ball to Luke Rogan, our man in pink today. This is a little tradition here in Toronto.
A great tradition. Such great support for the Arrows in Toronto, all of Ontario and
Cheers.
Canada.
Enjoy. You can go. Thanks, mate.
Linger day longer. I think we would have seen our first yellow card of the day.
All right, Rebecca, we're good to kick off. All right, Dan. Where are we? Good.
The Legion are north of the border. They are ready to go. Last time these two teams met, it was the Arrows winning in San Diego, 27-20. Legion looking to return the favor.
As you said, this is a different Legion side. Red hot, maybe the best run of any team of any form in the two-year history of Major League Rugby. What they've been able to do, winning five in a row, and their point differential, a whopping plus 136. That is almost double the next best team with at NOLA.
Again, we are in downtown Toronto for the first time. Jamie McKenzie will put his boot to this ball, looking for that fortunate hop.
Toronto has to use the home field advantage, get the fans involved early.
And this ball into touch early on. We don't have to wait long for our first set piece.
Set pieces will be interesting. I'm sure who has the advantage in the lineout, the scrum. It has to be to Toronto. See the first lineout coming for the Arrows.
Hey, Robin, yeah.
Andrew Quantrin, of course, your hooker for the Arrows, the 22-year-old out of Ontario from Hall of Landing. Able to deliver it in to Peter Malazzo. There's Parfrey's first touch. Again, John Moonlight not in the 23 last weekend in that victory. Again, this is a part of a busy stretch for Toronto. You and I saw Austin in New Orleans yesterday. Austin's already gearing up to travel up here for Thursday's clash with the Arrows. And then the Arrows will have yet another weekend matchup as well. So three matches essentially in a week span.
That's a busy week for the Arrows. We'll see how they're able to respond. A beautiful offload there from Shepard, keeping things going. You see a nice carry from Mitchell going forward. Toronto playing with a lot of confidence, a ton of momentum, dominating the defending champion last time out. Oh, what a ball.
Delaney, a little good fortune as that ball goes back into the hands of the 23-year-old from here in Toronto. Mitchell, they are starting to sniff that try zone. Arrows moving at will, looking to dot it down. And they will talk it over.
It looks like Cellini is able to get across. Beautiful teamwork, getting clean ball out quickly, going through the phases, and the pass is on the money, finding hands.
No try is the ruling after chatting it over.
The ball spilled out and then grounded. Wasn't a try for my scrum.
The referee said the ball spilled out and went forward, so it'll be a scrum instead. It's a huge break for San Diego, no try.
Yeah, you did not see the indication. Luke Rogan wanted to talk it over with his assistant. They'll bring it out 5 meters. Still an opportunity here for the Arrows.
They take another look, Cellini. They're at the line, hard to tell from that angle, but
they're ruling no downward pressure. That ball spilled forward.
Come on, there we go. Right.
Just didn't have control over it when he got across the line.
Could this be a break for the Legion?
If they need to win this scrum, then put boot to ball, relieve the pressure.
Bonds.
Nate Augsburger, he was brilliant against Houston. A win that catapulted San Diego to the top spot briefly this past week.
He's been fantastic at the breakdown, quick support lines.
Stay there.
Hit 122 meters on 7 carries in that victory over the Sabercats, just cut him to shreds.
These two teams were the darlings of last weekend. Toronto with a win at home against Seattle. San Diego, a dominant performance against the Sabercats.
No, stay there.
Of the 15 men of the week this last week in MLR, 8 of them featured from these two squads, 4 apiece.
And this has been the match everyone has had their eye on here in week 15. Toronto, they need the win in 6th place, 4 points off the 4th place Rugby United New York side.
Arrows, moments ago, thought they had their first try and a lead to work with. And unable to break the tackle there for Sammy Malcolm.
Oh, big hit that San Diego needs. Bow their neck, get something defensively, and try to get a turnover. Force a handling error from the Arrows.
Marcello Wainwright among the top 15 last week in MLR. Ball goes backwards.
See the pressure, the men in red swarming defensively.
Lazo able to free it up for McKenzie.
Clear release. His knees are on the ground. Clear release.
And you hear Luke Rogan explain after you make the tackle, once those knees are down, have to free him up so he can free the ball up.
Great stuff right there. Saul Wu-Ching putting the hit on his opposite number.
San Diego's defense again about to be put to the test here with a line out coming up for Toronto. Quatrin's ready.
San Diego dodged the bullet early. Toronto thought they found the opener. Luke Rogan said that was not the case. Toronto continuing to press.
We don't have those bright red try zones that we had over at York. But they are 7 meters out, almost a turnover. That's going to be a knock-on, presumably, against Wu-Ching.
And Wu-Ching thought he had it, getting involved early. Good to see the flanker making early plays for the Legion. And just got a hand to it, but nothing more.
And the Arrows will try to get that driving maul together again.
One thing here at Lamport Stadium, there is a narrow in goal area. Don't anticipate a lot of kicking in that vicinity.
There's the unmistakable Morgan Mitchell, your prop out of New Zealand. Well, the fans, they knew about the change of venue now here for the rest of the schedule over at Lamport Stadium downtown. And a great turnout again today. Both these teams, balls such great support at home. That's what you want. Make your home field a fortress. San Diego able to undermine that ball.
If that's the ball, how can he take it down?
He didn't take it down.
So the Legion have had their backs against the wall a couple times early, each time able to hold up.
Chilini again there. Thought he had something, but so far San Diego, fantastic job defending.
Feet up underneath you, yeah? Last one went down because feet up. Come up. Come up. I can walk through that gap. Come up. Down.
Came off the scrum last time, yeah?
Right
headgear, yeah.
Second.
Yep.
Crouch. Bind.
Former All-American at the University of Minnesota, Sit. Nate Augsburger, will feed this scrum.
Over extension.
So far, Toronto with all the possession, but have been able to find the opening points. They've had two opportunities. Great defending from San Diego, but they need to get the ball and try to get something going the other way. That high-flying offense is yet to be able to show it what it can do.
New Orleans with that win yesterday and claiming 5 points against Austin really has put pressure here on San Diego, because New Orleans at the end of this weekend will again have a game in hand. Really, that's putting pressure on everybody in contention for those playoff spots.
A tight match there. Give Austin a lot of credit. They trailed by just 5 at the break, but New Orleans, the goal, as they have done all year long, that offense finding its footing in the second half, and they're able to come away with a victory at home.
Well, that was the maul that Toronto needed a few moments ago, and they're going to try to relive it here in just a moment.
Little stab kick through from Moonlight. See the bounce here on this artificial turf surface. A tough bounce. No one in white able to get to it.
Malcolm, a couple weeks ago, had to leave early with an ankle concern.
Make sure when
we saw
it spins,
him back
we
in the lineup
around,
for that.
Don't just latch onto the ball.
Very convincing victory against Seattle last weekend.
What a win that was. They dominated the defending champions, held Seattle to just one try, 7 points in the entire match. That came in the latter stages.
About 10 meters down from that desired destination. Legion has the initial push.
Three's okay, three's through the middle. Joe. Where's Joe?
Looking for the captain.
Okay, it's a couple of times now. Yeah, it's the number of penalties. Next one's going to go to the bin. Have a chat to your boys for me.
Talking to Joe Peterson, your captain and essentially ambassador.
It's going to come out to the 15 anyway.
For San Diego.
San Diego needs to be careful. Just 10 minutes in already. The referee, Luke Rogan, telling Peterson that the next foul may bring out the yellow. That would put the Legion down a man for 10.
Okay. Number 3, dragging them all down.
It's the vice captain, Patty Ryan, who's put on notice.
Step that way for me, guys.
Yeah, no problem.
Step that way. Yeah, it's a bit difficult, so stay there. No, let's just play there, play there.
Arrows looking for that opening score here at home. And San Diego again has an answer.
Good job from San Diego. The first 10 minutes, they have defended almost entirely inside their own 22. They have yet to concede points, and a great job right here. Deflating at the very least for Toronto,
just
5 meters away and still unable to find a way to get over, and then the turnover compounding the problem.
See if San Diego tries to issue this one back to the captain, Joe Peterson, so he can put his boot into it, or if they have other ideas. We saw Augsburger, dangerous.
Fine.
Quick speed.
I must say, all the talk about the backs, and rightfully so for the Legion, but I've been very impressed with the forwards thus far. The pack doing a great job.
What does Nate have in mind here? They will give it to Peterson. And Dan Moore, just for good measure, perhaps a little product placement along the way. Line out coming up. Toronto thought they had a try in the opening moments of this one.
Yeah, I'll come to this side and have a look. Fellas, we just need to speak a little bit, yeah?
It remains Arrows ball. Very little possession has been with the men in red, and that is not a good recipe. The defense has been there, but you cannot play this way for 40 minutes, let alone 80.
Able to force the turnover on the lineup.
And this is what San Diego needs. Teo with his first touch.
Release the tackle player. He's on the ground. Let him go. Don't rip it out.
Mikey Teo already down. First time we've seen Teo with an opportunity to run with the rock. You always hold your breath.
And I mentioned what a relief it is, not just for San Diego, but all USA rugby fans, to have Teo back healthy. The injury last year, he came back in that ARC match down in the Lone Star State for the Eagles, the victory over Brazil. When he is fully fit or close to it, one of the best anywhere.
Well, again, it's Capelli Pifoletti who gets the start at hooker this week for San Diego. Pat Blair available off the bench. Got that start against Houston. Both of the brothers Pifoletti available today.
More. Good contest. Wrong now.
Good work from Toronto, able to get back with it.
This is a reminder not only that the Arrows have possessed for so long, but did so much of it in San Diego's half.
Hold that mark, Mo.
Teo finally will scoop it up. Mikey on the full into touch to set up the lineup.
Toronto playing the game they want thus far. The only thing they've yet to do is reward themselves with points, but everything in the Arrows' way, possession and possession and deep into San Diego. And
it's been a busy day for Mr. Quattrin.
Fellas, at last warning, we've got to get this going quicker. Yeah? We're taking a very long time to do this.
Watch another one of those Ontario natives, and the cohesion that the Arrows have. So many of these guys coming through the Ontario Blues program. That is a luxury that few teams in Major League Rugby have. They played together, some of them going on a decade.
McKenzie. And you sense the Legion starting to build some confidence, even without much possession here. For the first 15 minutes, Toronto's been knocking on their door, and each time they've been able to slam it shut.
Toronto having very little luck going into the teeth of that Legion defense, going up against that front row. Silvia Pifoletti, Ryan doing a great job.
Able to find a gap. Mieres.
That may be the ticket for Toronto, getting out wide. Gaston Mieres, the Uruguayan, found some space.
It's fine. He's got the ball.
And that has injected some life into things once again.
Nowhere for the Kiwi Mitchell to go.
Good hands from Moonlight. Well done, offloaded. Moore keeps it alive, or did he? And much to the discontent of the home fans, they will say in touch.
What a job there from the number nine, Jamie McKenzie. He was the one who started that foul. Moore outside, a beautiful ball. You see it right there on the money. Moore got it back to him, but was already out. Sent out Augsburger. A fantastic try-saving tackle for the Legion.
Augsburger able to route Dan Moore into touch and win this line out back for San Diego.
Where for Augsburger to go, tried to go topside into a wall of white shirts.
It's off a red foot play on.
It's what you want to see from San Diego. Power ahead, punch in tight. See if you can get that defense to suck in and then maybe use Teo and the rest of the backs out wide.
Theo Sauter, your fullback today. Now Moore ran right into the teeth of the Red Legion defense.
Wu Qing, not a man who's going to miss a lot of one-on-one tackles.
Here is Sam Wu Qing. Two offloads later, it's with Teo.
That's what Teo does, is able to stay up, finds the offload. Great rugby IQ.
Couple dummies to the left, a couple more to the right. Peterson chewing up the meters. Able to get it out to DePlessis, and it's San Diego with limited possession, able to dot it down for the first score.
Everything for the Arrows, the possession deep in Arrows territory, but a great run against play by San Diego, all started by Mikey Teo, who's able to find Peterson. Peterson, a beautiful run. Look at the offload. JP DePlessis would not be denied across and in. The visitors strike first.
It'll be the same chapter, Dan,
South
well,
African has given the Legion ground, the opening high, advantage.
Okay. Nah, I'm good, Jesus.
With the conversion pending here from the captain.
If you let him go.
I think San Diego has the speed advantage. You saw
it
there.
Yeah, we'll do the work after this.
Yep. Using the likes of Teo, Peterson, and DePlessis able to finish it off.
Made his South African debut a decade and a half ago for the national squad on the sevens level. Standout in Super Rugby, taking his talents to France and Japan, now here in the States.
You saw what the former Blitzbox man was able to do, just a bit of space. Sevens players traditionally just so good with green grass.
Flags will stay down, and the score will remain 5-0 for now. It's our first hydration break here at Lamport Stadium. Legion, defense able to hold, offense took advantage of a rare opportunity.
Okay, yeah.
San Diego on the road looking for its sixth consecutive win, already unbeaten in their last six matches.
Players are going to tackling players to ground, not releasing the player. We just need to clear that up.
Okay.
Let's see you and let's hear you. Arrows win.
Are you just dropping it, eh?
Yeah.
Well, belated birthday gift for J.P. DePlessis, who spent his birthday with a victory over Houston last weekend, making the trek with his passport up to Toronto this weekend. as San Diego has the opening advantage now, 5-0. And we see how Toronto responds. They had possession opportunities. You thought for sure it would be the arrow striking first, but San Diego was able to find some open space, and those talented backs from the Legion doing the rest.
Okay, time back on when you're ready.
Arrows in action today, as well as Thursday and next Sunday as well. Plenty of opportunities for fans to come check them out here at Lamport.
And for the Legion on the road, they will be headed down south to the Big Easy and then against Utah.
Talk about all the local talent from Ontario. Maybe a fingertip on that ball.
Backwards.
Arrows looking for the equalizer here early on. That'll spill loose and perhaps a knock-on as Mikey Tao unable to take it the other way.
That being told, there's a change at 15, a new fullback on for Toronto. It'll be Rio Odeman taking the place of Theo Souter.
There is the all of 19 years old Avery Odeman, who already is fourth in Major League Rugby with his 6 tries this year.
You talk about a young talent. Just absolutely incredible what he has been able to do in limited rugby experience. A very bright future for him. Anticipate him playing internationally, and who knows, one day. I'm feeling he's going to be hoisting some hardware. Might be this season.
If it's up to your friend Dan Power, Avery Odeman and the Odeman Empire wins Game of Thrones at the end of this season.
Without a doubt.
Arrows looking again for that opening score that's eluded them now.
No. He didn't move, so. You good?
Yeah. It has to be frustrating for Toronto. They've done things right. They've had the ball.
Now, Luke Rogan explaining it's a tough break for Toronto there. He thought Joe Peterson was not moving, and out of concern for Joe, halted the play.
That's the right call, and he said it perfectly. Player safety first and foremost, as it should be. A game as physical as this, you have the talent, the athletes, you have to keep them safe.
Jamie McKenzie, your scrum half for the Arrows, among the many men who have worn the red and white of Canada. He's from Oakville, Ontario, but born in Scotland. Now 30-year-old for the Arrows.
Earlier this season, the Arrows had 5 players on ARC duty with the Canadian national team. Able to weather that storm as the storm that their first 8 matches played on the road came away with a 4-4 record, and now they get to wrap things up here at home. Hopefully finish things in the top 4.
Wainwright among your first 15 this past week in MLR, along with Shepherd with this carry.
Shepherd, the leader of that pack, in every single way at 78 meters against the Seawolves. He's the guy you look to, number 4
now
in white.
Next one will go for anything down here. Points.
You've got to think San Diego's been lucky thus far. They've been warned on numerous occasions, but referee Luke Rogan so far has kept the mustard in his pocket. I don't think it's going to be long before it comes out if San Diego continues playing the way they have been.
Well, Sammy Malcolm and the Arrows want the points.
Well, in this situation, that makes sense. Only a 5-point match. You haven't scored. You've had opportunities. Give your team a boost, put some points on the board. We'll see if Malcolm can split the uprights.
Right now he sits 5th in Major League Rugby in kick accuracy, 81% of his kicks splitting the sticks. Trying to get that 0 off the board after San Diego, well, the cliche, has bent but hasn't broken.
Well, San Diego, one of our keys was discipline. They lead the league in penalties conceded.
First 3 points on the board, courtesy of the boot of Malcolm for Toronto.
Easily slotted through by Malcolm. And that's important for Toronto to get on the board. Just a 2-point game.
And of course, that will line Toronto up to get this ball right back.
Perfectly down the middle from Malcolm.
I hope there's some viewing parties in those downtown buildings. More. Had a big try last week against Seattle to help put to rest any hopes that Seattle was going to mount a comeback. All of a sudden, the Arrows defense playing, knowing that they're another kick away from taking a lead. This one skyward, well handled.
Yeah, beautifully taken there from Mieres. Does a great job. Tough ball and fielded it cleanly.
He's our lone man from Uruguay today in the starting 15. For Chris Silverthorne. An intentional knock on the call against Duplessis.
Yeah, there it is. You knew it was just a matter of time before San Diego picked up the yellow, and now Duplessis heads to the bin and the numerical advantage for the Arrows for the next 10 minutes.
So your lone try scorer is going to have a little 10-minute respite. Another look right there.
Yeah, that's an easy call. Duplessis, the intentional knock.
Just make sure we take a step in. I know the 15's a bit hard to see. But...
all of our familiar faces in pink throughout the league. A very elite, I would say, fraternity, but not simply men. Great officials here in Major League Rugby, really helping shape the style of play these first couple of years.
That's a great point. You can't say enough about the job they've done and really putting their mark on it. None of them want to be mentioned. They all want to go under the radar. They know they're doing a good job if that's the case, but got to give credit where credit is due. Now for Toronto, you have the man advantage trailing by just three. You have to find points.
And this one in a touch off the boot of Augsburger. As Oideman, they're going to bring it all the way out, back out, as that ball was off the boot from outside the 22, a miscue from one of the leaders of San Diego.
San Diego, the opening try from the man sitting in the bin, Peterson unable to split the uprights with the conversion. Malcolm found the first points for Toronto. Like to see Toronto get into the hands of more. Wait a minute, Mieres.
Outside shoulder, guys. Outside shoulder. Scott, line out.
Not a straight throw. In on the line out. That's a couple of miscues on line out today for the home sun.
He simply can't make those mistakes. Another good look at it there. Have to put it right down the tunnel.
San Diego was able to force the turnover earlier, probably factoring in the back of the mind there for Quatrin. Again, this is where San Diego has made changes this week. Sylvia and Hifaletti, your new men, with the vice captain Patty Ryan up front. Again, Capelli Hifaletti, the hooker.
And again, the boys up front, you mentioned them, Sylvia, Pifaletti, Ryan coming up big. Give them credit. Bermula, that's a KK behind him in the second row. Great work from the scrum for San Diego.
And when they see that head pop up of Andrew Quatrin, San Diego able to have a brief moment of celebration.
Maybe an underrated pack for San Diego. Their backs get so much attention.
They're gonna walk up and in. And we're gonna
go. The big boys up front aren't doing their job. Hard to get anything going.
Watch the rewind. Arrows had been advised to speed up their line out a little bit earlier. They wanted the same standard to be held here for San Diego.
Beautifully taken by the Legion.
Right in stride, good rhythm. Looking for their second try, perhaps, of the opening half.
No, it's been not forward.
Ball frees out.
Playing your advantage, folks.
Arrows playing with house money right now, working with the advantage.
See the electric youngster, Oideman, just unable to break the line and get through.
McKenzie able to retrieve it. Over to Wainwright.
Rare touch from Marcello Wainwright.
Able to break one tackle.
The bowling ball. Morgan Mitchell.
Backwards play on.
Moore keeps it in play. Fortunate it stays backwards.
That was the pressure provided by Peterson for San Diego.
Oh, fluid until that final toss when they were looking for Spencer Jones.
Defense for San Diego continues to do its job. Been very impressed. Pressure provided. That time.
Yeah.
Mattias along with Audsley.
Time's off.
The tailor's just pulling back there.
Okay, the message from me to you guys, we've got in and then we stood up. All right, if you stay straight and stay down in the contest, there's no issue there.
Even if he's
and
pulling back?
It will be very obvious.
Okay.
Okay, stay in and straight for me.
Luke Rogan hearing the favorite word that any official wants to hear. Okay.
You're not going to get any back talk from the Brower, the 36-year-old, the Lindsay, Ontario native. Has his 9 appearances for the Canadian national team.
Yeah, grew up working on the family farm. He understands listening and then following through.
Exactly. There are a lot of people that you may get something back. Rob Brower's not going to be one of these guys. He will listen, okay? He will pass on the message.
I can't scrummage without him.
No, I know that. The hottest day of the year.
So far, right? It's beautiful.
Major League Rugby. Yeah.
Beautiful. Why not?
Got some amateur meteorologists.
Hottest day of the year. Well, sure that is indeed the case. Doesn't seem to be affecting San Diego much.
Hashtag summer is coming.
Let's go, boys. Let's go.
San Diego able to strike for the opening try. Failed on the conversion. Toronto went for the points moments ago. Pull back within 2. Legion with the scrum here.
Toronto still with this man advantage. JP Duplessis still in the bin for just over 4 more minutes.
This side we're in already. This side, butts are pointing out and we're in. Expose the shoulder, let him go straight.
The way this match has gone, Toronto.
I'll try, yeah, I'll try.
Can't take advantage of being a man up. It's going to be tough for the Arrows to swallow just a 2-point deficit.
Seconds. A little more surface to grip shot, yeah. On this pitch than where Toronto spent their last 3 weekends. At
Bynes.
York Stadium.
It's a little softer, set. Different. You don't have as hard of a bounce, as hard of a surface there at York Alumni Field.
It's a long way.
I should say here as opposed to York Alumni Field.
Come up with your feet. With your feet. Let's come up with your feet, yeah? It's just here, boys.
I have to imagine there's a little heat rising from the pitch right now.
It's one thing about synthetic and artificial turf. It's easier to maintain. You don't have to worry about being covered in snow in the winter and the droughts in the summer, but it definitely absorbs the heat.
Bynes. Set.
Toronto playing its 4th straight home match. Still 4 more home matches to go before the end of the regular season.
Augsburger so adept at coming off the side quickly, making things happen. He sees a hole, he will take it.
Number 9's offside. Turnover was good, I was happy with it.
Offside call there, ball back over to the Arrows.
Arrows forcing the turnover. San Diego leads the league in handling errors.
And Augsburg, you see there, called for the offside.
Mattias lost it. Augsburger was in an offside position when he tried to get it back.
Mikey Tail.
Osley hasn't had the opportunity to get involved.
You say that. Down the far touchline, looking for support. That's a free ball, now an advantage for Toronto.
Great run by Augsburger, but didn't have a man coming in a support line, and it finds itself with the arrows.
Did that ball go backwards? Nobody's saying otherwise, as here's Quatrin.
Things starting to open up a bit here, the final 7 minutes of this first half.
Another minute left in the advantage for Toronto in terms of being up a man. Right now, Toronto is actually up two men. If you look at Legion with a man down right now, physically on the pitch. And Toronto wants an intentional knock-on, and there's the whistle.
Vermaelua thought he found a gift.
I'm going to go with just a knock-on.
Found just number five in red because of the intentional knock.
Different. It looked like a knock-on for me. Okay? I'm going to go with a knock-on. It looked like a knock-on for me.
Who's going down, though?
Again. That's four. No, we're up.
Right there. And again,
I'm not going to keep explaining
just
it.
A good old-fashioned knock-on will be the call that prevails. Meanwhile, concern right, for Dylan Otsley.
We've already seen one change. That came for Toronto as Avery Oideman came on for Theo Sauter at fullback 20 minutes in. Have not seen any substitutions for San Diego, but concern indeed is Otsley having to be assisted off the pitch.
The English-born Eagle.
Let's go.
Both of these sides are going to welcome that opportunity to retreat in the locker room. This was a moment ago with Otsley.
Yeah, it looked like Spencer Jones just came down on his lower leg.
Sit! Yes, sir! Steady! Stay in the contest, boys.
And Nick Boyer will come on wearing the 21 to take Osley's spot as the outside center.
Strong showing from the arrow scrum.
Collapsing. Three. Shot. Shot.
And again, with the missed conversion from San Diego earlier, Toronto right now, if they were to choose the points, and that's going to be the case, has a chance to take its first lead again off the boot of Malcolm.
Malcolm is able to make his first penalty goal. Manawatu Turbo's man, another opportunity, and now he can put his side on top.
Dan, just the boys are constantly asking every decision.
Okay.
Yeah, happily explain it to you, but I'm not going to explain it five or six times to five different guys.
Okay,
yeah?
Okay.
Does that make sense?
Can I get a chance to
talk? At halftime, yeah.
Arrows looking for the lead. Malcolm is money. Two for two today. And for the first time, a lead for the home side here in their new home of Lamport Stadium.
And how big does that misconversion from Peterson after the initial try from Duplessis loom for San Diego? Instead of a one-point Legion lead, it's the Arrows on top by one.
Well, we're back to even numbers now, 15 on 15 for the final minutes here in the opening half.
This match living up to the billing, both these teams to the tops in the league looking for the victory. Toronto on the outside of the top four looking in.
Arrows given the option of a line out, a scrum, or just have San Diego do it again, but you see the choice here.
Certainly makes sense for Toronto. Feel they have the advantage in the scrum. That power up front, Brower, Quatrin, Mitchell.
Crouch. Bind. sets.
Yes, heroes.
Hands on.
A virtual standstill here. Legion and Arrows. The Captain Moore. What does McKenzie have in mind? Legion for the first time today trailing on the scoreboard.
So far, both these defenses have done a fantastic job, haven't allowed either to get open, and that one find itself going forward into the hands of Oideman.
Yeah, we've seen a couple of these balls that they swing out here to the near touchline appear to go forward, and that was the case certainly on that one, as they're eager to get it out to Oideman.
Look at the close there coming in. Nick Boyer, the new addition, who's come on to take over as the outside center for Osley, quickly makes an impact.
Or how long is seven play?
Now, understand the ball itself moving forward is not the violation. It's whether the throw is moving forward. We certainly understand the laws of physics, where if you are in motion and throw a ball, it will physically travel forward. But it must be a lateral pass, and did not appear to be the case there.
Crouch! Bonds.
Next time you're on a train, drop something out the window and see if it moves forwards or backwards.
Again, a collapsed scrum. Had issues in the scrum. Very tightly contested first half. I think so far, Toronto will be a bit disappointed if they haven't been able to extend their lead. They had so many opportunities. They dominated possession in the first 15 minutes, almost entirely inside the San Diego 22, but couldn't come away with anything.
This Toronto scrum has strengthened. This scrum will belong to San Diego and Augsburger. We saw him hit a home run last weekend against Houston straight out of the scrum. And this time,
again, collapsing to San Diego. Legion scrum having issues. They've only had two real opportunities offensively, two 4As into the Arrows territory. They were able to come up with a try in one of them.
Again, a lot of shifting among the forwards this week in the starting lineup for San Diego.
Thanks, Rebecca.
That's where the Arrows remain fairly constant in their lineup. There's Dylan Oddsley, your three-time national champion at St. Mary's. Again, born over in England, but representing the red, white, and blue when it comes to rugby competition. Oh, an opportunity for Morgan Mitchell there for a moment.
Mitchell doing a good job offensively, making tough meters. And now Teo.
Mikey Teo off to the races. Boots the ball forward, knows he has the speed, and he has the try.
The machine, Mikey Teo, turned on the afterburners. No one was going to catch him. It looks like Toronto was going to head in. Maybe another opportunity, and look at this one. Knocked down. Great defense. Teo, the fortuitous bounce. And the Long Beach native, a kiss and a dot down for five.
And unlike yesterday's race, no disqualification. It's official, Teo with the try.
And that is what Mikey Teo can do. He said it in the open. He's the kind of player, when he gets the ball, you hold your breath. That is why.
How about that to close out an opening half? Looking for a conversion here from Peterson with the favorable angle. That's your final moment of the opening half. Mikey Teo gives San Diego its second lead of the day. They have doubled up Toronto through the opening 40 minutes of play here in Ontario.
All right.
Major League Rugby is brought to you by Sharp Business Systems. Transfer the day-to-day management of your network and print operations over to Sharp Business Systems. San Diego Sports Medicine and Family Health Center, providing the highest quality of care for families and athletes of all levels. And Falcon West Insurance Brokers, for all your auto, business, or home insurance needs. Halftime here in Toronto. Arrows saw San Diego reclaim the advantage just before the break. 12-6 our score. Let's check back in with Sarah down on the pitch with one of the reasons why the Arrows find themselves in the midst of a winning streak.
Yeah, hey Lincoln and Kit here with Arrows, Lucas Rumble. And Lucas, that first half, your team spent plenty of time in San Diego's zone. San Diego leads after the first half. What did you see from your team?
I like the effort from the boys. Definitely some things going our way. We just need to be more patient with the ball. We're forcing it a little bit too much. If we can hold on to it for that extra phase or two, I think we'll see a lot more results from it.
Okay, now getting to the common storyline of the season overall is that this is the inaugural season for the Toronto Arrows. You're from Toronto. Could you have called this a dream come true considering pro rugby didn't exist in Toronto? You know, it wasn't even talked about 5 years ago.
I guess you couldn't really call it a dream come true. It was always a dream of mine to play professional rugby. I just figured I'd have to go somewhere else to do it. So when this opportunity came up, it was just kind of surreal. And I jumped at it the first chance I could.
Yeah, of course, you have spent your career coming up through Ontario and playing for Queens here in Kingston, Ontario. Now, getting back to this season, you guys spent the first 8 games on the road. You've been home for about a month now. How has that changed things, not having to travel each week?
It makes the weeks a little bit easier. It makes recovery easier on the body. You're not getting on a plane 2 times a week, flying back and forth from home. So it just makes everything a little bit easier. Our schedule is more concrete. You can get into a good rhythm of things, which it's nice. When you're constantly on the road, it always feels like you're living out of a bag. You're never really in one spot for too long. So it's nice to be home, nice to have some consistency.
Yeah, certainly wears on you. And speaking of home, we're at Lamport Stadium today. Let's get back to the game, looking to the second half. You said you like the effort from the team. What else do you want to see from them?
Yeah, I think we just tighten up some of our set piece moves. And again, just hold on to the ball more. Don't force that extra pass. It's all right to play another phase and just keep going, because we're all over them when we have ball in hand.
All right, thanks, Lucas. And it's a beautiful day for rugby down here at Lamport Stadium, guys.
Sarah, thank you, and our thanks to the Crumbler for joining her here at halftime. Of course, went to high school right here in Toronto at Senator O'Connor. Arrows trail by 6 here at the midway break. Today's coverage brought to you by Cosmos, the Globe and Mail, and Honda. Lamport Stadium, the site of Major League Rugby on this Sunday afternoon. The sun is out. Right now, the Legion up by 6 against the home squad Arrows here at the half. Thank you.
second.
Well, the Arrows staff has really done a nice job putting together a match day experience here in downtown Toronto. They had that advantage 6-5 early on, and well, the early scoring actually started with San Diego after a great defensive performance.
18 minutes in, San Diego defending almost the entire first 18 minutes, but Peterson found JP Duplessis able to get the 5 in, unable to get the conversion. Then Sam Malcolm split the uprights, the penalty goal, made it a 5-3 game. He gave the Arrows the lead, another penalty goal in the 36th minute, and they had a 6-5 advantage before the final minute of the first half. Mikey Teo was able to show himself, but give Connor Kearns, the right wing, a ton of credit. Forces the turnover. You see Kearns right there. Mikey Teo with the fortuitous bounce, and no one was going to stop number 15 in red.
Mikey Teo created some of that good fortune. It started with the boot. It ended with the lips as he's able to dot it down on this pitch here at Lamport. Conversion was good as the Legion emerging from the locker room with that lead. That's the difference between playing a 39-minute half and a 40-minute half, as able to squeeze in points there in the final moments. Both teams have already dipped into their bench a little early in that opening half. We mentioned it's a hot day, so don't be surprised if we start seeing some fresh legs come out. We have already seen the youngster Oideman be a factor in this one, as the Legion have also stockpiled their depth as well.
And Nick Boyer came on in the 35th, taking the place of Dylan Osley. So both teams made a change. I have a feeling we're going to see more from the backs. Maybe Lavos comes on, Lupion for Toronto's, excuse me, for San Diego. We'll see if those two changes happen sooner rather than later, as it is a warm day here. Starting to take its toll. But a very tense, very tight first 40 minutes. Exactly what we thought we would see from these two teams. And it's going to be the mistakes, the miscues that may well determine who comes away with the victory.
Before the win against Houston last week, Toronto had alternated losses and wins throughout the season. They had actually never had a winning record, because literally they had never had a losing streak. They had never had a winning streak. Well, now they've put a couple of victories together, and there is even a midweek victory for Canadian rugby without the Arrows even suiting up. Nova Scotia, governing body for high school athletics, briefly ruled that they were going to discontinue rugby for boys and girls at the high school level. A lot of feedback quickly reversed that decision. The concern was in the safety, and reality was it appeared that rugby coaches and officials were actually just more honest about the reporting of injuries, which had brought them to the center of attention.
give them a lot of credit. They listened to the parents. They listened to the coaches and the players. They realized that their initial ruling wasn't correct, and they went back and reversed it. That's what you want. So a lot of credit there to rugby in Nova Scotia at the amateur and the high school level. It will continue, and that is a great thing.
Well, no, Rob Brower obviously still in the match right there. Your first 15 performer last week at Prof in the league. This was a back and forth affair in that opening half. Remember how it started with Toronto controlling possession. Thought they had to try early. It was ruled to have fallen forward into the try zone. They brought it back out.
That's exactly what Toronto wants to do. Good start here from the Arrows.
Looking for another lead. They were going to entrust Oideman, but they ran out of real estate as that one goes into touch.
And now real estate, Oideman just couldn't hang on, bobbled that one out into touch, did the youngster. And it looks like Toronto is going to be able to strike first. Beautiful going through the phases. And Oideman, I think he had it. He had the speed. Peterson was there, but he couldn't hold on. And that is the difference. It's been about the miscues. And you heard Lucas Rumble when he's joined by Sam Davis there at halftime. He said they've just been forcing things out of the Arrows. They need to keep the ball in hand and keep it away from San Diego. As good as San Diego is, doesn't take very much for them to get on the board, as we saw in the 40th minute.
Cinco de Mayo making its way north of a couple of borders. all the way up into Canada.
I wonder if they'll do the grito if the Arrows score.
I think most individuals with family ties and understandings of Mexico will tell you it's really more of an American thing. As Toronto, another miscue and a knock on. No. Catch a break here offside, the call.
Again, Connor Kearns, he was the man who forced that turnover that put San Diego up at the break.
Malcolm is 2 for 2 today, splitting the sticks. He's going to continue that pursuit, try to cut this deficit in half.
The way this match has been played, this is exactly what you would anticipate. The tee being brought out to Malcolm. He's in a good place. Has a fantastic angle, not too far out. You would expect him to be able to put this one through.
Remember, the Arrows with that win against Seattle did a lot of the other teams pushing for the playoffs a big favor. The problem is, doesn't mean that they're going to back down when you come to their house here in Ontario. And San Diego's experiencing a tough run at it here against a game Arrows squad. A tight battle.
So far, all 9 points for the home team coming off the boot of Sam Malcolm. Another three here with the penalty goal. Arrows first on the board in the second half.
So many great vantage points for the fans who have come out here downtown to take in Major League Rugby. Mike Shepherd.
Talk about how nice it is for the Arrows to be able to stay at home, to be able to train here, sleep in their own beds. And make no mistake about it, it's difficult to travel, especially the length of San Diego and Southern California all the way up here to Ontario.
Augsburger able to find that ball up in the Ontario sun. Teo. You had support on one.
A few times we've seen Devin Short able to get involved.
Legion looking to answer the kick with another 5 points. Wooching.
Just a beast. Takes two or three to bring him down.
Within 10 meters now. Ball spills loose. Still with the Legion. Teo spins forward.
What a handle by Mikey Teo.
No. Tackle made.
Patty Ryan inches it closer. They're not going to let him crawl in, though.
Fellas, it's going to be a held on because he's moved the 3 or 4 times. He's been tackled. So it's going to be a penalty for holding on.
And that's the call there. Once those knees go down, he cannot crawl forward. Trying to advance that ball.
Saw the vice captain. As Luke Rogan saw 3 or 4 times, he tried trying to inch his way across the line.
Just as the tackler must release him, he needs to free that ball up for play. And a break for Toronto.
San Diego possibly returning the favor. It was Toronto
who left
San Diego off the hook early in the first half, and now San Diego doing the same to the Arrows here early in the second.
Yeah, we still haven't seen any tries in that zone.
Maul.
Maul has formed here for the Arrows.
Now come around. Sit down. Around. Yeah, it's fine. Just don't change your binds. Yep.
I love the chaos that can go around you, and yet still trying to heed the advice of the man in charge. Piffoletti. Some big hitters with fresh legs, including Piffoletti now on the pitch. Not known for the hands, however.
A change made by Melosi. Piffoletti now wearing the number 17, comes on to that front row. You see him not used to having it, the immediate response he knew it. A man who doesn't get that many touches.
And what a rich rugby family the Piffolettis come from.
Come up.
Siblings and cousins, of course, their father, the Tongans.
Charlie.
That knock on creates this strong.
Crouch.
For the Arrows.
Set.
Jamie McKenzie still your scrum half here today for Toronto.
Standing up.
And again, we get Toronto called for standing up in the scrum. So let's see what San Diego's mindset is here. 3-point lead. Early second half.
Not asked for the tee as of yet. Been content to.
Looks like they're going to want the line out. Their eyes are on 5 points, as has been the case for really our top teams in the league this year.
They understand the importance of scoring tries, getting that try bonus. Had teams like Houston, Sam Winter, led the league last year in points scored. Houston too often has settled for three. They've asked for the tee, and it has not helped the Sabercats.
Let's speed this up.
Not just about the try bonus, but getting the victories.
With all the tries being scored this year, you really feel like you're not just up against the 15 men on the pitch with you, but also against the rest of the league battling for those bonus points. We saw New Orleans yesterday once again get the try bonus. There's only one match all year they have not managed to find 4 tries.
This is what you would expect from San Diego, the top team in the league in point differential at plus 136. That is incredible.
And this will lead to a scrum now.
Give you an idea of how good they are both offensively and defensively. The second best team in the league, NOLA, they're just plus 76.
Yeah, tackle.
Let's go big scrum again, big scrum again.
They're saying that's part of a tackle as opposed to an intentional knock on.
Contest.
Well, it looks like Parfrey not trying to get the ball until after it had already come out.
Will this be a productive scrum for Augsburger and the Legion? And you saw that
reset.
Tunnel collapse.
Look at that.
Luke Rogan thought there's a chance to feed that ball in. Now the end result likely would have been the same.
And you've got that pair of Piffolettis on the front row.
Say that again.
Joining Patty Ryan as Sylvia comes off as your loose head.
So Patty and the pair of Piffolettis up front for the Legion. Their scrum here,
set.
Right now, hanging on to a 3-point lead in Toronto.
Play it away. Stay there.
Keeps it. Offloads. Just wasn't meant to be. He was looking for Duplessis. Again, Peterson trying to play the distributor. That was the combination that came up with the first try. Well, JP needs to be careful. Already had the one yellow today.
This is what you would anticipate in a match with as much at stake, as much on the line as this one. You see Peterson just trying to flip it back, the offload, but I think San Diego's trying to say that was an intentional knock-on on Parfrey.
You can understand their argument there with Pat diving for that ball. Let's see if they talk about it. No, there will be no penalty, Tron. Instead, it is back over to Toronto.
Toronto may have gotten away with one there. The Arrows now making a change on their front row. Morgan Mitchell, tight head prop, comes off, giving way to Cole Key.
Kick up, boys, kick up.
Cole's going to turn 22 this upcoming Tuesday.
But wait a minute, the fullback at 19, Keith, not even 22, a lot of young talent.
Stay there, we're good.
It's a great sign, not just for the Arrows, but for all of Major League Rugby.
Arrows on their half of the pitch with the ball. Right now entrusted with Quatrin.
Are they through the middle? Pete, I see through the middle. Let it come, mate! Let it come!
Birdie coming. Going here.
Straight up, boys.
Up into that sun. Men from San Diego aren't scared of a little sunshine.
Lost forward.
I mentioned one of the warmest days, if not the warmest day of the year here in Toronto. And they certainly have to imagine that's an advantage for San Diego.
Well, the fans got the memo. Lamport Stadium, downtown Toronto, the new home of the Arrows.
Give the Arrow fans credit. It could be York Alumni Field here at Lamport Stadium, and they are out in blue en masse.
They went 2-1 the past few weeks at York. Again, they are all done with road matches unless they reach the postseason. And San Diego hanging on to that three-point lead. Able to take over in the scrum.
Less pressure on San Diego, trying to get into those top fours. They're already there. Toronto in sixth, looking up, 4 points away from the fourth place Rugby United New York team. They know that today, it's not a must win, it's pretty close to it.
Pifoletti getting re-wrapped. There you see both brothers.
Points. Shot goal.
Peterson asking for the tee. The first time we've seen this today from the Legion's captain. Fashionable and functional.
Yep. A sunny day here on the 5th of May.
He's happy with that one, but just make sure.
Seems like Cinco de Mayo always seems to just fall on the 5th. I'm not sure how that's possible.
Funny how that works out.
Yeah. Again, the captain.
Yeah.
He'll turn 35 later on this month. Off the sticks. As Cellini able to play it off the ricochet.
What a break there for Toronto. Peterson had the leg, but off the upright.
You should almost get extra credit for nailing the hardware.
It remains a three-point game. Huge turn there. New life for Toronto.
No tries today for the Arrows.
A bit surprised by that, as dominant as they were against Seattle, they were fantastic in all phases of the game. They haven't had that offense. They've had possession, but not the finishing.
These are points both these teams need. Arguably, Toronto needs them even more just to get above that cutoff line, whereas San Diego's more about positioning for the postseason at the moment.
For the teams in the top four, you obviously want to stay there the best seed you can. It's all about health. Kearns.
Yeah, Connor Kearns able to secure that one out on the wing. And San Diego and New Orleans still have yet to play each other, so they have two meetings coming up. And that could really lock up a top spot or devastate a team if they were to drop both of those matches. Looking for try number three.
Mattias unable to get away from Moonlight.
That's still a live ball.
Everyone stopped. It came off of Malcolm, but heard the referee Luke Rogan, still a live ball. Have to play through the whistle.
Let it come now, what?
Look at the organization, the defensive line for the Arrows.
Uching.
It's about faster for me, yeah?
Ian Augsburger so capable, even when he calls his own number nine. As Toronto able to come up with another stop. There is just no getting across that try line on this end of the pitch today.
John Moonlight there again, the firefighter. They've missed him a few times because of his day job duties. Fantastic work there, able to get it back. Man who's featured in 318 total matches on the World Rugby 7 Series and had a Canadian record by a stretch.
You see the hands on the hips. Both these teams will welcome that upcoming hydration break in a couple minutes. As we're just about an hour in. Again, Toronto won the first time these two teams met earlier this year in San Diego, but since then, San Diego has gone unbeaten in their last six, including winners of their last five.
Backwards, backwards!
Fortunate there, the Arrows. That one almost lost by Jones.
Shepherd.
Oh, charge down.
Some good fortune here for the Arrows.
Second time players have stopped before the whistle, which never came on either occasion.
And part of that is hoping for the whistle with a little fatigue setting in. Andrew Quatrin among the men who have gone the full 58 plus so far. It was Dan Moore who helped build some confidence last week for Toronto. Cellini. Back to Parfrey, who got the unexpected start today with a late scratch of Dutoit.
This is good stuff from Toronto, just holding on to the ball as I say that.
Both ways, guys.
That's what you want to see from the Arrows, those long extended possessions, keeping ball in hand, going through the phases, not forcing passes.
Not yet at that hydration break, but again, it will be a welcomed one. Both with how hotly contested this match has been and how hot this match has been.
Devin Short, the flanker down on the pitch being attended to. The Las Vegas native, the Heat, don't imagine it's bothering him much.
And Luke Rogan has indicated this is going to be the final hydration break. Right now, San Diego hanging on to a three-point advantage on the road. Legion up by three an hour into this one as Devin Short among the many changes among the forwards in the starting lineup this week. Short, the former high school rugby All-American growing up in Las Vegas.
A great young talent. Those players we mentioned there with such a bright future. MLR really giving them an opportunity to start their career. I heard Lucas Rumble at halftime, thought he would have to go abroad to play professionally, but that's not the case with Major League Rugby.
They've
been able to stay and sometimes even represent their hometowns.
I'm told these are not snowballs they're throwing. Lane Rose, Kevin McConico, Sarah Davis down on the pitch. Great to have you with us. As at this point last year, well, it was off season. When you talk about number of games on the schedule, essentially doubling with the addition of teams like the Arrows and Rugby United, just strengthening this league. It went so well, we're gonna do it again next year, adding three teams into the fold, splitting up the squads. San Diego goes to the west. There'll be an east as well. Six teams in each.
That's the good news, continuing to expand the league. More teams in that Northeast corridor, Atlanta coming in as well, have an Eastern and a Western conference. This is what the fans want.
Winner of the West and the East will each get a bye into the second round of the playoffs. As they do expand the playoff field, that cutoff line will move down a bit to six teams. And you see your new scrum half will be Andrew Ferguson moving forward for Toronto, still in the match, Nate Augsburger.
Toronto making their third change as Ferguson comes off the bench. Oideman came on early in the first half. Cole Keith early in the second.
Andrew, another May birthday. Turned 27 on Wednesday. Oideman still in his teens. Moore cuts inside.
Captain has had very few opportunities to get going.
Gaston Mira has just lowered a shoulder and cleared Teo out of your picture. There's Gaston right now with the ball.
It is. He's done a great job. The native of Punta del Este, Uruguay, one of the probably nicest places to call home of anyone in Major League Rugby.
They've got to go in front. You can't, yeah.
And we're going to have a man who wasn't even expecting to be on the lineup card today, Leandro Leivas, come on.
Yeah, and his countryman Leivas, the Uruguayan out of Montevideo, comes on into the match. Anticipate a big final 20 minutes to this one. It has been back and forth, everything we hoped for, everything we anticipated. And the balance still very much up for grabs.
Rob Brower sharing some secrets with Andrew Quatrin.
Hold.
Well done by the Arrows. Again, a try for the Arrows gives them their second lead of the day.
Not had a try thus far. All points coming up from the boot of Malcolm. All penalty goals.
Let him go!
He's perfect. 3 for 3. Nowhere for Wainwright to go.
Stay there, boys.
And as we have seen so many times in this match, when that Legion defense gets inside its own 22, it is another beast entirely.
No, play on. Timing's good.
Communication is so important here. It can be a struggle, though, when you start to grow tired. Parfrey. Oh, a sandwich.
Play me a bondage.
But still an opportunity here for the Arrows. Ball will spill, and they'll bring it back. Arrows were playing with an advantage.
Massive tackle from San Diego. The crunching sandwich, as you said. Wainwright brought down. Great work from the captain, Peterson, along with Boyer, but then all the focus on the ball carrier and left Waitman wide open.
Set up the line out.
Joe.
We'd have been unable to stay in. And this is an opportunity the Arrows must take advantage of, and it needs to be five.
I don't know that the San Diego players didn't get the worst of that. As you noted, crunching tackle. Not sure if they wound it up knocking heads or not. Off the fingertips. And there'll be no try, at least for the moment.
The long take on the lineout, always a gamble. Things like that can happen.
As the captain tries to get a little bit of breathing space for San Diego's defense now.
Instead of the Legion with their heels on the goal line inside their own five with possession and sends it the other way, does the Legion.
Avery Oideman back in the lineup today, coming off the bench, but came in early, the 19-year-old out of Mississauga here in Ontario. Looking for that seventh try of his young career.
We talk about how big that Ontario Blue side is in the Canadian Championship and how big they've been for decades now, producing top talent. Moore again corralled, the men in red not giving him any room. Moore, a big body, if he's able to get a few meters, pick up ahead of steam, so hard to bring down, but so far the Legion have been able to keep him from doing so.
Yeah, we're good.
So many near misses for both
going,
of these teams
keep
today.
Keep going.
With regard to their offense, of course, the defense has had a little something to do with it.
The defense of San Diego and of Toronto have done a very good job closing quickly. They've kept their lane assignments. The communication, as you noted, has been there. So important that it is.
How many fans of other teams around the league are just doing a little scoreboard watching right now? Take a look, 12-9, think, oh, they're probably about to approach the first hydration break of the match.
That's what you would anticipate if you were just looking at the score and not the match itself.
Looking for the dummy, but nobody willing to bite.
Very disciplined defensively.
Out to Levis, who just came on. Keith, 12 times capped with Canada. Oh, nice recovery for Parfrey, and then a high tackle, it appears.
Parfrey.
It's a number of them.
Had it, lost it. Augsburger immediately shown the yellow. San Diego was down a man in the first half.
Well, not just any man. Here in the second half, without their scrum half, been a dangerous man at them.
Duplessis put him down a man in the first half. They will be without Nate the Great, the scrum half, the high tackle, an easy call there. He knew it immediately, tried to let go, but it was too late. Luke Rogan on the spot. So not only is your scrum half out for 10 minutes, playing down a man, and it's just a three-point match.
Can the Legion stay organized in his absence? Second time today, Toronto playing with a man advantage.
Not able to take advantage the first time they had the numerical advantage. They will have to here. Looks like Nick Boyer will take over as the scrum half. Stephen Ng coming on for Toronto. He will plug in that front row.
And Stephen Ng's been a regular as that number two hooker for the Arrows, the 21-year-old out of Ottawa.
Fines. Set.
Arrows looking for their second lead of the day. Legion playing with just 14 men on the pitch. Shepherd still going strong. Arrows eyeing the try zone. Labus able to make his mark in the opening moments off the bench today as he dotted down.
Leandro Labus, the new addition who came on as a substitute. Uruguayan able to give Toronto the lead, their first of the second half.
The 30-year-old able to put his stamp on things. The Arrows with their second lead today.
Beautiful work there. Labus was not going to be caught. Teo, no chance, was late to get to him, and you see the reaction from the Arrows.
That's their first try today. It puts them back ahead.
Have you guys got in it?
A significant conversion here to preclude San Diego from just going for points to take a lead.
Labus, great step. Thought he was going to go inside, did Teo. Teo bit just long enough. That gave Labus the opportunity to beat him to that try line outside.
So Malcolm had the early penalty goals to keep them in the match. Trying to get them a lead for a second time with his boot, or rather stretch the lead here. It'll split them. That's a 4-point lead. Now for Toronto.
Massive. Point back to that initial conversion on the first try from Duplessis. The miss, Peterson unable to slot it through. Because of that, it is a 4-point Arrows lead and just over 10 minutes remaining.
And Dan Moore running as if it's just the opening minutes of the match.
Always astonished at what kind of shape the captain is in. He leads by example.
Take him back.
Never appears tired or winded.
Stay in front.
Teo, always dangerous. Little hesitation. Anytime you tackle Mikey Teo, it's a try-saving tackle. Labus comes through there.
Labus getting it done on both ends of the pitch. The try, then the try-saving tackle.
They test the right wing. It may be a short-lived lead for Toronto.
Good support line, Gaffney there quickly.
There's been something about the try zone on this end of the pitch. Teams have gotten close. Just have not been able to dot it down.
Fletty tried to use that big body.
Just 5 meters out. Is he able to dot it down? And they're going to bring
too
it back out. 5 meters.
We're going to go scrum. Yeah, there's too many bodies on the ground, and it's. We're going to go scrum, fellas.
See the mass of bodies between the uprights. And that is a win for Toronto. Great response from San Diego, moving quickly after giving up the try to Labus. The conversion from Malcolm put him in a 4-point hold, quickly down the pitch with the Legion.
Remember, Augsburger, usually the man running your scrum, is out with the yellow card. So here is Nick Boyer. Man with all the California ties getting to play his career for San Diego.
It's not necessarily the strength of the Legion. They're a better team playing quickly with space. You see it, or yes, I should say you saw it in that previous sequence. They're going to have to get this scrum, get it.
Legion looking for a crack in that back line of Toronto. They are in. San Diego is back on top.
Good call, my word.
And when you need a try, go to the captain, 35 years young, or soon to be, I should say. Peterson, the South African, the former Blitzbot, would not be denied over and across. Fantastic quick response from the Legion.
Ferguson did his best to try to hold that ball up. Peterson would not be denied. And now a chance to again expand upon this lead so that a Malcolm kick would do no worse than just tie it up.
What a match this has been. Outstanding in every phase. Coming down to the final, as you would imagine, as you would hope.
Even traffic wanting to slow down and gather a peek.
You mentioned the nearby office buildings. I'd be charging admission premium for those seats.
Fresh off his try a moment ago, Peterson looking for the conversion. And he has himself to thank for the favorable angle. Another lead has been exchanged. It's back to San Diego in their five straight wins, six matches unbeaten. The last team to topple the Legion was Toronto.
Eight minutes remaining. Question is, who has more left in the tank?
Take him back. Stop in front.
Another change coming in that front row for Toronto is Brower. A loose head prop, one of the elder statesmen, comes off, giving way to Pat Lynott.
Ing. Remember, the Arrows just one try so far today. San Diego with three. They'll play the advantage here, knock on the call against San Diego.
And Kearns there again, he's been
still playing
all
here,
over
not
the park
advantage.
Defensively as Connor Kearns.
Too far out to dabble with perhaps a drop goal. And they'll bring it back.
No advantage, come back to the lost forward. In the tackle, yeah. Cross forward.
Say it's a big scrum. I think every set piece big from here on out.
You see some of the originals still in there among the forwards for San Diego, and Veramalua along with Nasser KK and Wu Ching impressed with their conditioning. Obviously, they're no stranger to some heat out there on the West Coast.
The Legion making a change at left wing as Nick Lupion comes on and take over
Bynes
for Ryan Mattias.
Set.
Peter Milazzo among the Ironmen today for Toronto.
Both teams trying to get fresh legs in for this final push.
Stay there, 21.
Early dummy buys some time.
Davis has been outstanding.
He was able to find Mieres. Looking for support. A friendly bounce to Shepherd. The Arrows quickly have entered the red zone.
Again, Davis playing the distributor.
For a second time today, Oideman runs out of real estate over there.
Oideman is skilled, as quick as he is, just hasn't had the space. Thought he was going to be able to get around that final tackle. You see Leandro Levas, beautiful offload to Oideman, but Oideman unable to get away. Again, Connor Kearns there defensively. He has been outstanding, the right wing for the Legion. He's made some huge tackles.
So Legion able to force Toronto in touch, line out here for the visitors. Can the Legion hold on? Could we potentially see just our third ever tie in Major League Rugby?
Well done. Tylon.
Oh, miscue on the line out. The jump came too quick. The throw wasn't timed correctly.
And Tom's fine. Shoot is fine.
A try for the lead here late. If you're San Diego, you have to be able to play cleanly here.
Legion know it.
And here's a decision to be made.
It's a clear attempt to slow down the ball. It's a cynical. He's going to the beach.
San Diego's down 2 men.
The third yellow card of the match for the Legion.
Clear attempt to slow the ball down.
Eklupien, no, excuse me, rather.
Well, Toronto, rather than kick for a tie, still pursuing the scrum here. Get your index finger, count the red shirts. You'll only find a baker's dozen.
He had a chance to roll. He had a couple of chances to roll, and he laid back.
Okay.
We got time off because we got a sub coming off for the yellow card. Yeah, we're good, guys.
Daniel Waldron, who'd been on the pitch a matter of minutes, heads to the bin.
Number 20.
He'll be there for the remainder of this one.
Hey, 20.
Yeah, he's going off the back, Rebecca.
That'll force Patty Ryan to come back on.
All right, let's go. Time back on.
Toronto opting for the scrum. Against, same thing applies. San Diego has to play cleanly here. Cannot give up a penalty try.
This match has lived up to all the hype.
At the same time, the Arrows, you have to come away with some form of a score this trip down.
Toronto has time. They don't need to force anything. Just keep possession. They know that San Diego has to play cleanly. And even though San Diego leads, got to think the pressure felt a bit more on the shoulders of the men in red right now.
Again, Ferguson, your scrum half for the Arrows now.
Set!
5 meters away from pay dirt.
Yes!
A plan in place. Francis was the first leg of it. Arrows are in, and for a third time today, have the lead here at home. With a minute and a half to spare.
Incredible stuff from the Arrows. Coming back, able to get the try. They went down, they responded. Back on top. Malazzo with the try.
Could the Legion streak be ending?
We will kick off.
And ultimately furthering that of Toronto to 3 in a row. Another significant kick here.
Back and forth.
Yes, yeah, we will have a restart.
It has been the entire second half.
There will be time for a reset, a restart.
Yeah, Luke Rogan assured the Legion
to go, Sam.
There's still 2 minutes to
go,
be played.
For your kick. Cheers.
No mistake. What that means is San Diego will not have a chance to simply tie this game by splitting the sticks, let alone take a lead. San Diego must find the try bonus to even manage 4 points here on the road. First, they need the ball.
Toronto with it. Waiting to hear time is run out before they send this one out into touch and the celebrations begin. That being said, can't commit any mistakes, no errors, no penalties.
Toronto has won their last two. No indication yet that it would be full time from Luke Rogan, who keeps the official time. Now that indication, now that win streak is at three. San Diego had gone 6 matches unbeaten. Their last loss at home to the Arrows. Looking to avenge that loss instead, the streak comes to an end in Ontario.
An incredible match, back and forth, what you would expect. Great offense, fantastic defense, but ultimately the home team coming up with the try in the final 90 seconds to give them the win.
Arrows not just spoiling other people's plans, but perhaps making their own plans for the postseason here in year one for Toronto in Major League Rugby. When we come back, we'll have a chance to talk to our man of the match. Arrows capture 4 points today here at home. A Stephen Ng try for Toronto in the closing minutes gives them the 4 points for the win. San Diego will manage 1 point as they leave Ontario with a loss bonus. Lincoln Rose, Kit McConica with you. More importantly, Sarah Davis is with one of our men of the match. Sarah?
Hey guys, yeah, with Sam Mitchell. And Sam, what a wild last 10 minutes there of the game. Can you just take me through from the 70th minute, what happened?
Oh, it was a bit of a seesaw battle, to be honest with you. I can't really recall what happened because it went so fast. But, I mean, credit to our boys. We held them to the ball. We knew we had to get down there and score points. We could have taken a three at the end there to tie the game, but we needed the win. So 4 points is awesome for us moving forward. And, you know, we're going to take every game as it comes and hopefully, you know, get into the playoff spot. But credit to San Diego. They came out with a pretty good performance. We knew they were going to come with a good intensity, and they showed it out there today.
Yeah, San Diego was solid defense throughout the entire game, especially at the end. How were you guys able to break through there in that 79th minute?
Oh, yeah, like I say, I mean, we just had to hold on to the ball, build pressure, and eventually it just took its toll. We're just so proud to get the win and get a win in front of our home fans.
That's three wins in a row. How do you feel about that?
We're excited, but, you know, we just got to look forward to for every game as it comes in the next 4 weeks. Yeah, look, we're stoked with the win, but we still got another job ahead of us.
Great stuff. Thanks so much.
Thank you very much. Cheers. It's awesome.
Yeah, Sammy likes multiples of three, but he doesn't mind if perhaps they stretch it to four. Now let's check back in with Sarah.
Oh, hey, guys. I'm with Aaron Carpenter now. And Aaron, last week we were talking about you guys getting on your first winning streak, back-to-back wins. Now you put three together. What did you see out of your team today that allowed them to really push through, especially there at the end?
Yeah, I just think they finally getting on the right page together, and their never-say-die attitude. They knew they were going to win that game throughout their entire time, and they stuck to their plans and processes and got the job done.
And what about a couple of these guys coming off the bench today? Leandro Levis, Steve Ng scored the two tries for you.
Yeah, they made a real impact, and that's what we tell the guys. When you're not in that starting 15, you want to get that shirt and come on and make an impact and make it tough for us. So then next week, leading into Thursday, we'll have some tough decisions to make.
That's right. Looking ahead, it's three games in 1 week. Do you change your process on how you prepare at all?
I don't think we change our process on how we prepare. I just think we rest some of the guys knowing that we got another game a couple days after that. Use our extended squad and give a lot of the guys that haven't got as much time a little bit of playing time. And hopefully they can do the same thing these guys did.
Great stuff out here today. Thanks so much, Aaron.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Guys.
And what a resource to have Aaron as an assistant on that staff, your most capped Canadian. Perhaps he could find himself in the 23 this week. Again, here are your new standings. Nola Gold has to be thrilled. They had to assume that San Diego was going to capture multiple points and find themselves perhaps back in the driver's seat. But Nola is atop the table now again with a match in hand on many of the other teams in the postseason push. Meanwhile, Toronto continues to climb. They forced a tie with Rugby United. But again, remember, San Diego and Nola, they will meet now twice in this final three-week span for San Diego. Their only other match will be a trip to Utah. As for the Arrows, we will see them back here on Thursday against Austin, next Sunday against Utah, then matchups against Glendale and Rooney. For Kim McConaughey, Sarah Davis, I'm Lincoln Rose. Toronto in a back-and-forth battle in their Lamport debut. Do not disappoint. The Arrows have won three in a row, moving into Thursday night's match against the Elite, right back here in Ontario.